Hello, Lizzy.
Hello, darling.
How are you? Lovely to see you again.
Lovely to see you. Bought you a little present.
Oh, fantastic. We like this, don't we?
We do indeed. Shall we open it?
Shall we open it now?
Yes, please. Let's take you back to the beginning, when you first met George.
Right, well, I met George in Tramp. And actually, it was just after I found out that my ex, John, had done the dirty on me. And my friends pulled me out and said, get yourself together, you know, go out. And it was about a week later, and I went into Tramp, and George was sitting there.
Did you recognise him? When you saw him, did you think, oh, my God, there's George Best?
I did. I mean, I didn't really know that much about him because my father's, you know, really big into rugby.
So George was how... He was 26 years old, isn't
he? He was 26 years... Well done. Good.
Wow.
That's right. He was 26 years older than me. So, yeah, he was about 47, I think, then. And we just sat down and we just started talking. And we found that we just got on really, really well. We were just in our own little bubble and everybody else around...
Didn't
really matter. And of course, you know, it was a bit of a nightmare at first because my parents,
who
obviously, my mum had grown up in the 60s. I had to keep it a secret from them for quite a while. So that was a big, the age gap.
Yeah. Well, his reputation with women, I suppose. Any parent would probably worry for their daughter
Absolutely.
A little bit. But was it love at first sight in a way when you saw him, or was you just instantly obviously got on very well?
Well, we just instantly very mutually attracted. I felt as though I'd met my soulmate. We just found that we just got on so well. And when I left that evening, he said, can I have your phone number? And I said, well, get a piece of paper and a pen. And he said, no, I'll remember it.
Did he?
Yeah. And he said, I'll call you tomorrow. And, you know, are you doing anything tomorrow? And I said, well, no, because I was an air hostess at the time. And
right, yeah.
I was on a holiday. And so he phoned me up and he said he'd take me out for lunch. He took me to a baked potato place.
Oh, my word, baked potato on the first day.
He said, I'll meet you in my local pub. And I think, being young and naive, thinking going up to London, it's going to be a fantastic, you know, ritzy, smart wine
San
bar.
San Lorenzo. Or...
Yeah. No, it wasn't. It was his local pub, which was called the Feeney Arms, and it was just tucked around this little side street and full of old-age pensioners and all the Chelsea, you know, the old Chelsea
How
soldiers.
Funny. Did you know it was coming? Did you have any inkling he was going to ask you to marry him?
Yes, because he kept talking about it. I'd been away on holiday and I got back and he proposed. And then we got married 2 months later.
Oh, really? That's quite quick.
Yeah. But, I mean, you, George, you had to get
him. You had to get him quick while he was still...
You had to get him on a sober day as well. But, no, I mean, it was a lovely day. And I just remember sitting in the hairdresser's a week before we got married, not knowing that I was going to get married.
God.
And George phoned me up and said, I've just been queuing in the registry office, Chelsea registry office, all morning. We're getting married next Monday at 10:30.
Oh, my God!
And I went, what?
Look, most people have about a year to prepare for their wedding. You had a week.
I had a week.
So was it the kind of day you envisaged? Because there must have been a lot of press and...
It was fantastic. I mean, the night before, I locked George in and took away the keys, just in case he decided to do disappearing...
disappearing
acts. ...to Tramp and then suddenly forget that he was getting married in the morning.
Yeah, that was a wise decision, I think.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So it was Hobbs 10 wedding, so we got picked up. We went to the registry office. So I was absolutely shaking. My legs were like jelly.
Yeah.
And then afterwards, we were back to the pub.
Oh, there's a shock.
He's local. And the landlord had promised that he'd put on a nice spread for us. Anyway, we got there. There was nothing there. The landlord was doing something with a pipe. He was wearing shorts.
Were you panicking at this stage? Were you... What did you...
Not really. I mean, the wine was absolutely warm. So we had another venue planned. And it was out near Heathrow. And it was a lovely old pub, but it was right off the runway.
This is the most bizarre wedding I've ever heard about, my God.
But no, it was an absolutely great day. Everyone ended up going absolutely paralytic. We ended up going back to the King's Road to Pucci Pizza.
Pucci Pizza.
And absolutely shattered by 6 o'clock. We were absolutely shattered. So we went home, passed out in bed. That was to everybody, didn't
My
it?
God!
And then we woke up at 1 o'clock in the morning, full of beans. So I put on my wedding dress and we went to Tramp.
I can't believe that,
and
Alex.
And had a bottle of champagne.
Oh, darling, it sounds fantastic.